Okay, algebra 2. Today's learning target is I can solve systems of linear equations of two variables using substitution. We've already looked at how to take a system and graph it to find the answer, whether it had one solution, no solution, or infinite solutions. In the last class, we looked at elimination, and now we're going to go on to a third method to solve the same types of problems called substitution. Okay, so for your notes today, the substitution method, you're only going to use this method, use substitution, when one of the equations is either already solved for the variable, or it can easily be solved for x or y. So that's my suggestion to when you're going to be using this this method. So you're going to use it when the equation's already solved for the letter. It can be solved for x or solved for y. Or if you notice that one of the equations can easily be solved for one variable, then this is a good method to use. After the equation is solved for the variable, you're going to substitute the expression into the other equation. So once you get the first equation solved, you're going to substitute, that's the name, the expression that it's equal to into the other equation for the correct variable. And then you're just going to solve for the remaining one. Okay, first example. You notice that I see in the first problem, a y is equal to negative 2x plus 10. That equation's already solved for y. The second equation is 3x plus 4y equals 12. The directions ask me to solve by substitution. So what I'm going to do is take this part, which I'm highlighting right now. Since y is equal to negative 2x plus 10, then by substitution method, I am allowed to take this piece and actually substitute it in place of y in the second problem. So this is what it will look like. You'll end up seeing a 3x and then plus 4. And instead of writing down y, you're going to substitute the expression from the first equation. So negative 2x plus 10. Okay, now following this equation, I have my 3x. I brought down my plus sign, my 4. I now change the y to what it's equal to, and then the rest of the problem says equals 12. So since the first equation is solved for y, all I did was take the expression, substitute it in place of y in the second equation, and now what should happen every time, if I do this correctly, is that the remaining equation will only contain one letter. It'll be the same letter, and you should be able to solve for it fairly easily. Okay, so let's continue. Next step would be 3x, and then you have a 4 outside of parentheses, and you learned in Algebra 1 to distribute, multiply the 4 times the negative 2x and by the 10. So we're going to do that now. 4 times negative 2x is negative 8x, and 4 times 10 is a positive 40. And then that should be equal to 12. Okay, we're going to combine like terms. 3x minus 8x is negative 5x. And we have plus 40 is equal to 12. In the next step, you're going to have negative 5x is equal to 12 minus 40 when you transpose. Okay, then you're going to be left with negative 5x is equal to, and then 12 minus 40 is going to be negative 28. Okay, then you're going to divide through by negative 5. And then when we simplify, your job is to see if there's a better way to write 28 over 5. I do see two negatives, so I'm definitely going to change it to a positive value, of course. But there's no number that divides into both 28 and 5, so we're just going to leave it as 28/5. And so this is our x value. And just like the other methods we've learned, when you find an answer to one of the letters, your job is don't stop. You have to go back and choose one of the original equations, and I'm going to pick the first one because it looks easier. Y equals negative 2x plus 10. You're going to substitute your answer that you just found for x in place of x in the equation. And then you're going to multiply negative 2 times 28/5, and that's going to be negative 56 over 5. And then you are going to calculate that, negative 56 over 5. I'm going to jot that down again. And I'm going to change 10 to a number divided by 5, because when you're adding fractions or subtracting fractions, you have to have a common denominator. And so I think this will make it easier to see. And so y is going to be equal to a negative 56 plus 50, which is negative 6. And when you're adding or subtracting fractions, after you find the common denominator, you just keep the same denominator. And so it looks like my answer for that one, for the y value, is negative 6 over 5. And so just to finalize it, this system is intersecting. And it does cross at the 0.28/5. If we were graphing, we would probably want to use a decimal there, and -6/5. And so that's your solution to this system. Okay, let's try another one. We're still going to stick with the substitution method. We notice on the first one, we see x plus 3y equals 5. And it's definitely not solved for either variable. Likewise, the second equation. And so now it's decision time on your part. There's always different ways to do this, but what I like to do is pick the equation that I feel is the easiest to solve. I also always look to see if I can see a 1. If there's a 1 in front of a variable and x is a 1 or has a 1 coefficient, usually that means that it's going to be, or always means that it's going to be easier to solve. So I think I'm going to choose the first equation and I'm going to solve for x. So x is equal to, and that means I'm going to come up here, I'm going to grab this 3y and I'm going to transpose it over. You can put it in front of the 5 or behind the 5. It really doesn't matter in this method, because you're just going to be substituting anyway. So I'm just going to drop down the 5 and then minus 3y. Okay. All right, so now I've changed the first equation and solved it for x, and this is what it's equal to. X is equal to 5 minus 3y. So anytime I see an x in the other problem, I'm allowed to substitute that highlighted piece in for it. So this I can put right there. Okay, so I'm going to try that. Okay, so below I'm going to have a negative 2, and instead of writing x, I'm going to type in the 5 minus 3y. Okay, so this represents the negative 2x. And then for my equation, it says minus 4y, so I have to bring that down. And then it says equals negative 5. Okay, so you won't change the rest of it. And now we are ready to solve. We have to distribute the negative 2. So negative 2 times 5 is negative 10. Negative 2 times negative 3y is a positive 6y. Drop your minus 4y down. Equals negative 5. Okay, step by step, we got negative 10. We're going to combine 6y minus 4y to give us a positive 2y equals negative 5. Okay. Now we just need to transpose the negative 10 across. Bring down your negative 5. Change the negative 10 to a positive 10 after you transpose. Now the problem reads 2y is equal to negative 5 plus 10 is just 5. And you'll divide by 2. And then you can make the call whether you're wanting to use a decimal or a fraction, but if it's a stopping decimal, like this is just 2.5, then 2.5 would be okay to use. If it's one of those repeating decimals or kind of messy decimals, then my advice to you is just stick with the fractions because they're more accurate and it's a definite answer. So y is equal to 5/2. I'm going to choose the fraction answer. Okay, so now I need to go back up and I need to pick one of these equations. But you also could choose this one because this is just a different version of the original, like the first one. And this one to me looks the easiest of all three of these. Let me grab this really fast. Of all three of these equations, this third one looks the easiest. So I'm going to choose to use it. I'm going to jot it back down. And then scroll down here. My answer was 5/2, and that was y. So I'm going to say x is equal to, or can be found by doing 5 minus 3 times, and then 5/2. So x is the same as 5 minus, and order of operations tells me I have to multiply here first. I can't subtract 5 minus 3. So I'm going to multiply 3 times 5 over 2. And that's going to be 3 times 5 is 15 over 2. Remember, you multiply fractions straight across. And I see subtraction, so I'm back to like finding a common denominator. 5 is the same thing as 10 divided by 2. Of course, if you're using a calculator, it does it for you, but this is the thinking behind it. Okay, 10/2 is the same as 5. And then you're going to do x is equal to 10/2 minus 15/2 is the same thing as negative 5/2. Okay, so grab my highlighter here. And that's that answer. And so to file laws last, you are to write down your answer in ordered pair form. Be careful, make sure your x always goes in front. So negative 5/2, comma, positive 5/2. And that's the solution. That's the solution to this system. And that's using substitution. Okay, we'll try one more together today. Number 3 looks a little different. I notice I do still have 2 equations, of course, so it is a system. But this time, both of them are already solved for y. So this to me looks more like a graphing type problem. But the directions are the same as the previous two. We have to use substitution. And so this one actually, in my opinion, is one of the easiest ones. Because all you really have to do is, if it's already solved for y, this is what y is equal to. So you can actually just take that 5x minus 4 expression and put it in the other equation. Remember to always go to the other one and just substitute it in place of y. So if y is equal to 5x minus 4, and they're telling me that y is also equal to 7x plus 6, then it should make sense that those two expressions have to be equal. So 5x minus 4 has to be equal to 7x plus 6. And again, notice that your equation that you're left with, this is how you're going to know if you're right, it only contains x's, okay? Or if it only contains y's. If it only contains one variable, then you know you're on the right track. So you're going to solve this by transposing. You're going to transpose the negative 4 to a positive 4. Combine like terms, 5x minus 7x is negative 2x. And then 6 plus 10 is, or 6 plus 4 is 10. It's easy. Then we're going to divide by negative 2. And finally, x is equal to negative 5. Okay, so I've got my x answer first. All right, if x is equal to negative 5, then I come back up here. So now you're going to select one of the first equations. And again, it does not matter what one you pick. I'm just going to go with the first one. Y is equal to 5x minus 4. And you're going to substitute a negative 5 in place of x. That's what we just found. And so y is equal to negative 25 minus 4. So y has to equal a negative 29. Okay. And so that's it. I have my two values. I'm going to write it down as an ordered pair form. Please remember to do that. And you're good to go. So negative 5, comma negative 29.